Hey, I want to talk to you about uploading an entire file into ChatGPT. I used to do it the hard way, but I recently came across a way easier way to get it done. And that's kind of one of the criticisms of ChatGPT, right? That when you go to it, you can say, write me a 500-word article about podcasting, and you might not like what comes back. It might be really generalized and talk about the ever-evolving landscape. And why? Because you only gave it this little bit to chew on. And I have had a lot more fun, a lot better success and results with ChatGPT when I give it more to chew on. And if you've ever looked into how to deliver better prompts, they say that, well, you can edit it yourself or kind of guide it and say, do more of this or less of that, or add an interesting story or funny statistics, or they say, write this piece of text in the style of Robin Williams or Eddie Murphy. But the real secret is in being able to give it huge amounts of input. Give it a whole chapter, give it a whole book. And how do you do that? Well, I like to record using this tool that we're looking at right here called OBS. And you just click on start recording and it records your web camera and your microphone. And then I go and use this tool here called Descript, where I can say somewhere in here, I can click on this and say add file and import an MP4 video file and say insert into script, and it will automatically transcribe really accurately. Not 100%, but it says save there of recordings folder. And then I can just take this and say publish export transcript and then output a, so export transcript and output a plain text file and even add like time codes and things like that. But here's, and so if I save this, here's what happens is if I load what I just saved. So if I take that big long, I think it was like a 40-minute, 34-minute audio, if I control A and control C and select all this and I paste it into ChatGPT, let's see, I'll start with a new chat. So new chat, and I'll paste all this in. The message was too long. What do we do about this? Well, what I used to do, which was a little cumbersome, was I would have a prompt like this. I would say, the document I'm about to share will be divided into several parts. I request that you wait until all parts have been provided before summarizing or answering any questions about it. In the meantime, please respond with acknowledged. I will wait for all parts before proceeding. And then what I used to do was I would go in here and I would say, well, let me copy like the first 10 minutes and then let me run this through and let me show you how cumbersome this is. So we give it this prompt that basically says that I will give you this in pieces. So we go here and we'll start a new chat and we'll have it try to understand. And then we say, all right, well, let me copy this first 10 minutes here and I'll paste it in there. And it's already, I'm like, no, it's already summarizing. And for some reason, I have better luck with ChatGPT 3.5. So then I'm like, well, let me start again. Maybe this one will follow directions better. So wait until I get all the parts and we try this again and we give it this part. Acknowledged. Okay, I'll wait. So now this one listens. So then we put in 10 through 19 and then you put this in. Okay, acknowledged. But then what I noticed is that sometimes I don't know the right size and sometimes I paste in too much and it's irritating and it's, you can see how there's all this back and forth. And sometimes if a chunk I'm pasting ends in a question, then it tries to start an answer. And then the other problem also is that if I paste in a chunk, it doesn't always transition. Like if I paste up until here and then I paste in here, it doesn't always connect the two. So what's the better way to do it? Well, I installed this plugin, which I'll show you in a moment. The plugin is called ChatGPT File Uploader. and it adds this extra button right here. And what happens here is we can say new chat, and so it adds this kind of upload button, and I can take a file, an article, understands, I think, PDFs, Word documents, text documents, and I can take this transcript, and you see how it's kind of doing this parts uploaded, and it tells ChatGPT how many parts, it pastes in the right size, it even does a little bit of an overlap in the pieces, that way ChatGPT understands all the transitions. So I pasted all this in, and then it says, I finished reviewing the document and I'm ready to assist you with your inquiry. So now that we've given it more to chew on, we can say, use what I sent you to create a 500 word blog post. Ensure it covers the why, what, how to, and what if aspects of learning. Start with a powerful hook, a thought-provoking question that sets up the problem, explain the problem and possible alternatives, jump into the solution, perhaps with step-by-step instructions, if that makes sense, summarize, talk about next steps and what is possible now that they have this information. I might save that and use that later on. And so now, have you ever found yourself in a coding conundrum? Why use ChatGPT for coding? What ChatGPT can do? Debugging, defining your problem, learning the possibilities. And I did a screen capture tutorial. It ended up being about 40 minutes. And I said, make this into this whole thing. So why wait? And then we can go and massage it and say, can you add a funny joke at the end? And just massage it into what we want. There are two types of people, those who can extrapolate from incomplete data and the other ones. So you can see that it works way better if you can give it more to chew on. So how do you do this? Well, this is, as we said, this is called the ChatGPT File Uploader Extension. So we remove from Chrome, we remove, and let's just start from scratch. So we open up our Chrome tab. We go to the hamburger, they call it, on the right side, the three dots, extensions, manage extensions, and then click on the Chrome Web Store. And then this is called ChatGPT File Uploader. And the one I prefer is this Uploader Extended one. I tried another one, it didn't work too well, so File Uploader Extended, because as it is now, when we go to ChatGPT and you go to chat.openai.com, there's no upload button. There's just a way to give it a prompt or do that cumbersome paste it in chunks. So you add to Chrome, add extension, and I believe there are some settings, but not really much. So if you go click on the puzzle icon and Maybe I was thinking of something else. Yeah, there's not really anything to set there. But when we go and refresh the ChatGPT page, oh, there we go, there's the settings. It's in this little gear icon. And you probably don't need to change any of these, but it's kind of cool that you can customize remember I showed you a few minutes ago, so kind of the setup of how you explain it, how it's chunked out. But anyways, all you have to really do is just click on this upload icon, and then, I guess we'll give it the same text document again. So we'll upload the parts, and then now that it has all this to work with, we can kind of give some prompts based on that. So now we can say things like, give me 5 to 7 takeaways. So important lessons or task or assignments. I should perform after learning this. I'm on the edge of my seat. Understand code, document, user-friendly solutions. Or we could say things like, generate 10 possible YouTube titles for this video. Make sure to follow SEO best practices, including using a primary and secondary keyword and limiting to 85 characters or less. Step-by-step OBS scripting guide for screenshot capture. Maybe I don't like those titles. Redo the titles to mention ChatGPT and AI more prominently. AI-powered ChatGPT. So there we go, we have some choices there. I can say, write full podcast show notes, analyzing and summarizing this information. Include a summary at the beginning, establishing the problem and solutions. Mention relevant talking points, including timestamps if possible. Key quotes and URLs if they are mentioned. We delve into, and they always say things like delve into a fascinating journey of leveraging ChatGPT and AI. Key talking points, the role of ChatGPT, finding a solution, conclusion, key quotes. And then I might say, be more detailed in the talking points sections. Make each area a paragraph of 3 to 4 sentences, not just one sentence per talking point. Okay, better. And it's all possible because we installed the ChatGPT File Uploader Extension, which adds this upload button, and then we can upload a whole entire file and then give us something based on what we uploaded. And I can say even things like, well, brainstorm for me 10 possible phrases to use in a YouTube thumbnail for this. I want the phrase to be 2 to 4 words and include some relevant key phrases. Or based on this video transcript, come up with 10 new unique ideas for future videos I should record. So simple AI automation unleashed. ChatGPT powered automation, mastering OBS, video editing, OBS scripting, and we use this ChatGPT file uploader extension to make it happen for Chrome.